Abby, welcome to the Kelku Review Show. Today we're joined by Joe.
Hello.
We are going to be reviewing extreme sports cameras. Good. Red, awesome, totally wicked.
I can't even tell you how much we had to pay her to do that.
Yeah.
No, anyway. So, yeah. Shall I get going?
Do it.
Okay, first one we're going to look at is the GoPro Hero, and this is basically the top of the range. So this is kind of ideal for anyone that's doing anything extreme, so skiing, anything even more extreme than that, anything underwater. It has functions and features for all needs. It's about 300 quid just for the main camera section, and then there's this, which is a viewfinder, which sits on the back, and that costs about another £80. So the two are sold separately, but there's a reason why that is. We can work it out, but I'm sure there is. They snap together, and basically, it allows you to view what you're filming.
Is so, that just for the setup, so you can set it up?
Exactly, yeah. So, obviously, you can't really view while you have it strapped to your face.
Shall I strap
this to my face?
Yeah. My hair, okay? Don't touch me. Okay. Oh, it's really big. Let's pretend that it's not falling off. I'll hold it, it's fine. I'm working it.
Yeah.
I'm really into this, yeah. Don't punch me in the face by accident.
Oh, I can't even get this open. There we go. So that, basically, that bit fits in there, like so. And then...
Getting concussion.
It's a bit tricky. Should have practiced this, shouldn't we?
Yeah, maybe should have done it off my head.
There you go.
Okay.
And then you can tighten that up if you want, but up to you.
But you haven't got the viewfinder on it.
Yeah, so you basically, you don't do that. You get a friend to set it up for you, or set it up when it's not in your head. And then there you go.
Can
so
I just say, this is really heavy.
Is it, do you think?
Whoa, yeah. Yeah, I literally feel like I'm just gonna fall on my face.
Yeah, it is quite heavy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think if you're genuine extreme though, you wouldn't really say things like that, would you? You just kind of deal with it. Anyway, right, so it's got only two buttons, which is good for when it's actually on top of your head because you can't be faffing around with menus and things. But to set it up, it is a bit of a pain, isn't it? We have to press about 8 different combinations in order to get it to do what you want.
Yeah.
But you do that once a day, basically. So once you're set up, you're ready. It's on top of your head, press.
And these, like, you've got one for the head, but can you get them?
Yeah, you can buy things to go on your chest and you can strap it to whatever you want, basically.
And your arm?
Yeah, I think they've got a whole range of accessories.
Okay, how many, what's the stats on it?
Quality-wise, it's really good. It's basically, as I said at the beginning, it's basically the top of the range camera for the extreme sports market. And it will do 1080p filming when you're filming at normal speed. And if you want to go to 50 frames per second slow motion, it'll basically give you 720p. So it's very, very, very good quality. And it costs 300 quid, but you know, a camera that gives you that high definition generally is a lot more expensive than that. So I think this is a pretty good price.
Yeah.
For the quality and the fact it's got so many
different...
It's
a bit fiddly, like there's a big instruction manual, like the yellow pages.
It's
quite a lot of work.
Yeah, I think it's worth it though.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to take that back? Well, next up we have, it's actually stuck to my arm, the Action Cam. This is $24.99.
That is a bargain.
That depends. Depends what you're looking for. It's not waterproof.
True.
It says it's shockproof, but I think
it feels a bit flimsy, doesn't it?
It feels a bit like it might break. Also, I've managed to set this off. This is recording now. It has a little light on the side. I'm going to demonstrate this one because I can't get it off my head. My head's grown. It's because I'm so extreme. So it's not flashing now, is it?
No.
Yeah. So
press
then
the
I
little
do.
Button on the
yeah,
side.
That's.
Oh, you've got it all covered.
Who's doing this product, Joe? I think it's me. Yeah, it's me. This is also squeezing my brain. So what you do, you put it on your head, this tight, and you press the button on the side. Hang on. There we go. I know it's on because of the noise, but also there is a flashing light on the side, so I can check on my hand, is it going? Yeah.
It's useful, that noise. All the cameras we've tested have all got something that when it's on your head, either a noise or you can look at a light on your hand so you can see it's there. So definitely check out for that if you're buying one of these.
I don't think that's actually, we'll move on from that. But I'm just gonna take this off my head. Look at my extreme hair. extreme, it's because I'm so extreme. So actually what we found though was that if you were doing anything other than standing still, the picture quality was quite bad. Like,
awful.
I don't know what you could use this for. I mean, walking, you might get away with. Go into a gentle jog,
Yeah, I'd say
picture quality is really bad. I'm just gonna.
Even extreme walking, it struggled with.
Extreme walking. I do a lot of extreme walking, yeah, and it struggles.
It only costs 30 quid, basically. So it's not a lot of money.
$24.99.
It's not a lot of money, but frankly, considering it's marketed as an extreme sports camera, it doesn't do the job.
Yeah. So that's that one. And it could make you look like a Dalek. Right, carry on.
Number three. Do you want to hold that? Thank you. Right, this one, look at that, it's been in my pocket the whole time. This is what is known as a lipstick camera. It's obviously very small, and for that very reason, it works, does the job. That one you said was really heavy, this is the exact opposite. I feel like that is.
Oh, wow, hang on a minute, my hands are full. Okay.
Crazy.
Yeah, that is. Well, how do you...
So it comes with...
Do you put it in your mouth?
you probably could actually, yeah.
Yeah, how do you actually attach?
So it comes with some accessories, and it's kind of, it doesn't have all this lot, full kind of head straps, but you can buy them. But it does come with a little thing that you can hook onto the front of a bike, for example. Mm-hmm. So this is kind of, this is good for BMXing and things like that.
Right.
You sit on your handlebars and then away you go.
Okay, how do you know it's on?
You know it's on because, now this actually is one of the least excellent things about this little bad boy.
Least excellent.
Very modest way of putting it, right?
Least excellent.
See that? That
is it more better?
It's a flashing, yeah, that is more better than anything I've
seen.
So yeah. That is flashing blue and green.
Is it?
Not very obvious. That's all you've got. It doesn't beep, so you kind of need a mate to, like that, and then, is it flashing? Which could possibly cause problems, but.
Can I just have a look at this? Okay,
it
no,
is flat,
I mean,
yeah.
You can, yeah, you can see if you sort of put your fingers around it and make. How much does it cost?
It's £125, so somewhere in the middle of the three we've looked at.
Mm-hmm.
Gives you 720p recording quality, so it's pretty good.
Okay, and is it waterproof?
It is waterproof.
Okay. And what, so it's just got two buttons, is that quite difficult or?
Similar to the GoPro.
Why don't I just drop £89 worth of stuff all on the floor? Yay!
Okay, do you want to hold some of this?
I don't know. What do you reckon?
I think I'm ready. Go for
okay.
it. Go on. Right, so this...
So what would you go for?
Right.
Why don't you take that, because that's one product. I'll just carry this. Okay. This is really heavy anyway. Extreme.
So what will I go for, I think, is the question.
Yeah.
Well, this one. But possibly this one, depending on my budget. That one, I think, is useless. You may as well just use your phone camera.
Yeah.
Complete waste of time.
Yeah.
This, it's kind of 350 quid with the viewfinder, and it's quite a lot of money, but the picture quality is amazing.
It's actually, we saw 389.
389, sorry.
Yeah.
The picture, we saw some videos that have been taken on an actual ski slope. Unfortunately, we didn't get sent to an actual ski slope, did we? But anyway, it looked good. This one, pretty good. It's 250 quid cheaper. So I think one of these two, depending on your budget, that's the way to go.
Okay. Extreme. Extreme. I'm so extreme. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Where did you find her?
I'm really extreme.